you and welcome to St George's Park for the Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships 2015. My name is Stephen Jamieson and I'm joined on the commentary today by Bobby Cowsill. A very good morning to you, Bobby.
Morning, Stephen.
This is another playoff classification match and this time it sees the Republic of Ireland take on Argentina. A very warm welcome to all of you joining us on the live stream around the world today, but for the benefit of those here with us at St George's Park, utilising the audio description service, here is all the information that you need to know. Our commentary position is situated just on the halfway line opposite the main stand here on pitch number two. To our left is the Woodland area and to our right immediately is the Argentina dugout, and further away to our right the Hilton Hotel complex, just to allow you to gain some perspective on the commentary and hopefully enjoy it a whole lot more. If you're not sure where you're seated or if you require any other assistance or information, please do contact your nearest steward or official. Now, this game is an important one for both teams. They're searching to qualify, or to finish rather, this tournament in as high a rank as they can. The winners of this game will go into a playoff for fifth and sixth place. The losers into a playoff for seventh and eighth. They will play the winners and losers of the game coming up at 1 o'clock, USA versus England. So either one of these teams could go into a mouth-watering clash with the hosts tomorrow afternoon. And we await to see who that will be. But the team's out on the field at the moment. Argentina in a navy blue kit, navy blue shorts and shirt with their white socks. And Ireland, as they have been for almost every game in this competition, in all green. And a very important game coming up for both sides, Bobby.
Yeah, as you mentioned, the ranking important and could be important going into Olympic year next year as well. And after the presentation party make their way back, we shall have the national anthems, which have been really well appreciated so far and really well sung by some of the teams as well.
Yes, we'll leave you with the national anthems. We'll be back with the team news after this.
The national anthem of the Republic of Ireland. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Argentina. Gentlemen, it is our round three match here at St George's Park, Cerebral Palsy Football World Championships 2015.
The national anthems then, perfectly observed as ever. I'm a big fan of the Argentina one, I don't know about you, Bobby.
Yeah, real classical tune that.
And we'll run you through the teams for this game. Technically classed as match number 37, it has no real official title, but these are the playoff games really for the playoff quarterfinals to determine the final positions of this tournament. Running you through, the Argentina team first. In goal, Gustavo Nahuelkin. And outfield, 2, Pablo Molina. 3, Mariano Cortez. 4, Rodrigo Lugarin. 5, Matias Bassi. 4, Rodrigo Lucas, 7, Rodrigo Lugarin, he's the captain. 11, Matias Fernandez. And for the Republic of Ireland, in goal is number 14, Simon Lestrange. And outfield for them, number 2, Joe Markey. 4, Luke Evans, captain. 5, Eric O'Flaherty. 7, Gary Messett. 8, Carl McKee. And 10, Dylan Sheridan. Now, we saw both these teams only a couple of days ago, Bobby. Ireland lineup with a very similar lineup, but Argentina made several changes.
Yeah, they have. I'm really looking forward to seeing sort of Luka Modric look alike. Rodrigo Lugarin, the captain, with his longer blonde hair. He didn't play in the last outfit, and you tell me to expect impressive stuff from him.
Yeah, Lugarin is definitely one to look out for, as well as the number 5, Matias Bassi. He's the engine room in the middle of the park for Argentina. Gets about really well. He's their FT8 player. Teams are permitted only one FT8 classification disability and must have at least one level 5 or 6. Argentina have 2, level 5 in goal, Gustavo Nahuelkin, and level 6 up front, Matias Fernandez. Ireland's level 5 is Simon Lestrange in goal, and their FT8 is Dylan Sheridan, who will play on the wing.
So apart from that, I'm really looking forward to seeing Gary Messett again, a bundle of energy in the game a couple of days ago.
Messett with that wonderful left foot, the Irish number 7. It's a cloudy day here at St George's Park. Sun threatening to peak out just a few minutes ago, but it's tucked itself back in behind the clouds. And it's once again perfect conditions here pitch side for what will be another great game at this championships. We're very much looking forward to this. Referee officiating this one in a yellow jersey, black shorts and socks is Keith Stroud. He's assisted by Jorge Barbasan and Minesh Gupta. Fourth official is Carlos Diaz. So here we go then. Argentina with the kickoff. Blue shirts, blue shorts, white socks, Ireland in all green. Argentina kicking from left to right as we look at it. Opposite the main stand, and they get us underway here with Matias Fernandez, who immediately finds his namesake, Matias Bassi, who immediately drives over halfway into the left channel and towards the left side of the area. We said he was all action, and here he is. But a good tackle there on the far side by Messett, and Ireland can work it away. And eventually here falls to Gary Messi, who turns away from Bassi and plays the ball down the line. It's a good one too, looking for Sheridan up top for Ireland. He can't quite control it though, and it's well cleared. And Bassi popping up on the edge of his own half of the centre circle here to pass it to Molina, and then out wide here on the near side to Lugarin. Into the middle of the defence for Luquez. Just approaching halfway, and he's got Bassi ahead of him, and then out to the far left is Mariano Cortez, who swings in a cross, but that crossed the touchline on the far side. There'll be an Ireland throw. And I warned you, Bobby, Bassi has been everywhere so far.
Yeah, absolutely, all action. Really impressive the way he carried the ball early on, beating two or three players, getting to the edge of the box.
It is an Ireland throw on the far side to be taken by Luke Evans, who is the skipper. Very, very reliable defender is Luke Evans, as we've seen throughout these championships.
Well, Ireland have the throw-in on the far side. In front of their fans, a splattering of fans in the three-tiered terraces opposite us. Enormous tricolor.
And here we go into the Argentina half through Sheridan. That's well cleared by Luquez on halfway. There'll be a throw into Ireland on this near side, almost bang on the halfway line. Maybe just a touch inside their own half of the fields. Yeah, so Flatty with the ball in his hands. He's got Messett in close attendance. And he bowls it back up the line. Underarm. So if he flies it up by Markey, but that curls out of play on this near side. That'll be an Argentina throw, I think, or is it the foul being given? It has indeed. Markey was clipped there by Matias Fernandez. Free kick to the Irish just inside their own half on this left-hand side.
Yeah, I think just caught his foot there as he followed through the Argentine, so first free kick.
It will be the number 2, Joe Markey, to take it. He plays it in low along the deck to Gary Messett, who plays it back to Joe Markey. Left-back position, plays down the line towards O'Flaherty. Lugarin is in quickly, but O'Flaherty gets the second ball. He's barged off it by Matias Bassi. And here comes Molina. Into the middle goes Matias Fernandez in the centre circle. It's now back with Bassi, the number 5 for Argentina. It's now with Luquez. He plays it to his right to Pablo Molina. Down the line to Lugarin on this right-hand side, inside the Argentine half. Edge of the centre circle in Irish territory is Bassi, but he can't quite work it through to Lugarin. And that in the end is cleared by Ireland all the way up to Sheridan on halfway. And he finds Markey in the left defensive position now, crossing halfway for Ireland into the feet of Dylan Sheridan. Good feet from Sheridan. Swings it, a great ball, and a flick on, is it? No, it goes all the way past the far post. Wonderful ball in there from Dylan Sheridan, and Ireland nearly on the score sheet.
Yeah, great stuff from Sheridan, the number 10. Fast feet at first to just make some space past his man. Swings in across from the left side. And how it evades Carl McKee, I'm not quite sure. And a way out for a goal kick only, but a good opportunity.
It certainly was a real early chance for Ireland. Very, very close indeed. Here's a throw into Argentina on this near side. It's going to be taken by Rodrigo Lugrin. He takes an orthodox throw down the line towards Fernandez, who tries to hook it over his head towards the onrushing Lugrin, who continued his run after taking the throw, but it's hooked clear by Ireland, so halfway, and then into the middle of the field by Sheridan, but that's to no Irish shirt, and Argentina can come away with it on the far side. There's that throw-in on the far side to Ireland. It's given away cheaply to Fernandez, that's a free kick, says referee Keith Stroud. Sloppy foul there, over on the far side by the Ireland number 8, that's Carl McKee. And it's Mariano Cortez who stood over this free kick. Bundles of energy down the left side and a good delivery to boot with his left foot. 3-2 aim at in the centre, Fernandez, Bassi and Lugrin. And it's Cortez who swings it in. Eventually, plays it in low to the feet of Bassi, who'd peeled away to the front to take the ball back to goal. And he gives it back to the right side of the halfway line to Molina, who floats it up towards half, towards the penalty area rather. And in the end, Fernandez can't control it. 50-50 on the far side. And that goes Ireland's way for a throw-in. Almost level with their penalty area over there on the far side. Just in front of the huge Irish flag in the stands. And this time it's going to be an Argentina put-in. As Ireland rather cheaply give it away with the throw-in. Cortez with the ball in his hand. Rolls it in left-handed to the feet of Fernandez. He jinks inside and manages to squeeze out across. It's a really good ball, but a good header away from Flatty. Eventually Messett will calm things down in the midfield and played out to the left side of defence for Luke Evans. And I can see the dugout is up next to me. It's Bassi who's gone down. Not too sure what happened. Our view is rather restricted.
Yeah, it seems to be a coming together between Gary Messett and Bassi. The referee's reaching for a card here. And it's a yellow card for, well, for both of them. Bassi looks absolutely furious about that decision. Messett less so.
Well, the Argentine bench right next to us is furious about this decision. My Spanish isn't the best, so I can't tell you what they're saying, but I can tell you they're very angry. Head coach Osvaldo Jorge Hernandez, really not too pleased with that decision at all.
But, tell you, Stephen, it's a good job you don't speak Spanish.
As, it is going to be Ireland's ball. And in the end, Ireland can get it back and away. Edge of the D with Joe Markey, fights the free kick forward. Interestingly, it seems to be given as a free kick to Ireland, despite both players getting booked. But anyway, here's Bassi picking it up in the centre circle. Yellow card won't stop him. It's Rodrigo Lugrin winning it now in the centre circle off O'Flaherty. Good strength from Lugrin, tenacious play. That's the left-hand side for Fernandez, who goes back at the line to Cortez. Challenged well by McKee. Really good battling away by the Irish winger on the far side, McKee. Tries to swing in across, but Sheridan was nowhere near him, really. And in the end, it rolls harmlessly through to Gustavo Nahuelkin in the Argentine goal. Number 12 in the red shirt. There's that. Molina comes away now on this right side of the Argentine half into the feet of Bassi on halfway. Back to goal, but he turns and feeds Lugrin in down the right. He's got Matias Fernandez in the middle. Checks back onto his left foot, looks to curl it in, but it's a good bit of defending from O'Flaherty. And it'll come here on halfway on the left wing to Sheridan, who skips away from Molina beautifully, but Molina bites back at him well. Gets a tackle in. Just threatened there, Sheridan, to get away. Argentina back in possession with Bassi on halfway right side. Comes over to the far side now to Cortez, who keeps possession for Argentina with Luquez. And down the left side it goes back to Cortez, and a thumping challenge in there from McKee. Referee signals another foul. Pretty broken up game by Keith Stroud so far in this game. And it's going to be a free kick to Argentina just inside their half left side.
Yeah, no real rhythm to this game at the moment. A few loose passes and some good tackling. Breaking things up on a frequent basis.
This is Luquez, who plays it to the feet of Bassi, looks to turn again. He feeds Lugrin, he takes a shot first time, but that won't trouble Simon Lestrange in the Irish goal, who falls away down to his left-hand side to comfortably gather. He rolls it out to his left to Markey. He demands players to come to him. A ball lofted over the top down the line towards O'Flaherty, but that's too heavy. And Molina will comfortably deal that out to Lugren on this near side on halfway. But it's a loose pass into the centre. It's picked up by McKee, who plays into the feet of Sheridan, back to goal towards the edge of the area. Plays to the left side of his own defence now on halfway. Is Markey, challenged by Fernandez, goes down the line now to O'Flaherty by the corner flag on this near side. Back to goal, challenged by Lugren, who gets the tackle in. That'll be an Irish put in, level with the penalty area. Towards the feet of Gary Messick, great tackling by Lugren. He really is a tenacious player. A good clearance too up the line to Matias Fernandez, who can then complete the clearance down the line. And Bassi has pace, but so does Luke Evans. And he'll get there first, the Irish defender, challenged by Bassi. And Luke Evans has to flick it away for an Argentine throw halfway inside the Irish half on this near side. Bassi is a great athlete.
A short, stocky little character, reminiscent of Javier Mascherano, something that you pointed out to me before the kickoff.
Yeah, there are similarities, very much so, that you can draw with the 11-a-side game. And Bassi to Mascherano is one of them. Two very, very good Argentine footballers. And the ball just sticking around in the corner flag down by this near side. And Fernandez in the end as well to force an Argentine throw off of Markey. And it'll be Lugren to take with the put in on this near side. And he rolls it in short to Fernandez. He's going back to goal by the corner flag. Threatening to play it off a couple of defenders. He does and gets another throw. I think Argentina are really hoping for a corner there. They've got no real player in this team with a really long throw, which can come at a disadvantage. But they keep it short again. It's Molina back up the line. Looks to feed Lugren, who lost it high towards the edge of the area. Bassi brings it down his chest. Gets there first before Messick, then takes a shot left footed, and it goes just wide of the near post as we look at it. Really good effort from Bassi.
Yeah, really unlucky, Bassi. The ball was high in the air. He brought it down fantastically on the chest. Made himself a few yards left of centre. The left foot strike whistles past the goalkeeper's left post.
Ireland keep hold of it in their own half. Messick is fouled by Bassi, and those two have to be careful. Bassi there in danger of... Yeah, it was Fernandez, sorry. My apologies. It's Fernandez with a foul on Messick there. Thank you very much, Bobby. But yeah, correction, that was Fernandez with a foul. He's in danger of getting his first yellow card, not indeed his second. And Keith Stroud is having a chat with Fernandez. He says no more. And it'll just be a free kick to Ireland. Midway inside their own half, right side. Luke Evans stood over it. Irish skipper, long sleeves, as are all the Irish players. It goes into the centre circle then for Messick, who spins. Plays it to this near side now for Markey, who crosses into Argentine territory. And a great strike left footed. Oh, it goes just wide of the far post. What a hit that was from Joe Markey. Nehuelkin wasn't confident that was staying out.
Yeah, whistling left foot strike on the angle. Approaching the corner of the box here on the left hand side. Flies past the goalkeeper's left post. Would have been a tough one to keep out if it had been on target.
Really, really strong strike from Joe Markey. Goal kick to be taken by Rodrigo Luquez for Argentina, and he plays it to this near side, short to Pablo Molina, and he goes up the line to halfway to Bassi, who controls again. Battle between him and Messick has been fascinating so far in midfield. So Luquez, who flights a long one towards Fernandez, may drop it for Bassi with the volley. Oh, it was so close for Matias Bassi to a fabulous goal, and the Argentine dugout just behind me really making some noise at that one, so close.
Yeah, the lofted pass not dealt with properly, and it bounced down to Bassi, who continued his run. Right of centre on the half volley, stretching to get there, did really well, but it's just wide.
Played just shy of 12 minutes in this first half, and a couple of great moments. And again, the Argentina dugout to my right is animated as the free kick goes against them for a foul on Markey on halfway.
It appears South American flair's not only on show on the pitch, but also on the bench.
Keith Stroud asking for the free kick to be taken back by Joe Markey to the requisite area, and it is. And he's got plenty of men in the middle here. Four men in the penalty area for Ireland. Only Luke Evans back. It's Markey who takes the free kick. It's deep towards the goal. It's a really good delivery, and what a leap that is from Mariano Cortez to head it away. One of the smallest players on the pitch, but one of the highest jumpers by the looks of things. Here's Lugren on halfway. Matias Fernandez inside the centre circle, twisting and turning past Evans. Flicks it out to the left-hand side with the outside of his right boot, and down the line it goes from Cortez into the feet of Bassi. Now with Fernandez to give it back to Cortez, and he's held up a little bit on the far side by McKee. And then in the end, we'll go out for an Argentine throw on the far side, just inside their own half.
Yeah, a little bit more goal mouth action in the last few minutes as the raindrops begin to fall.
We're in danger of getting wet in our commentary position as Molina comes over halfway, middle of the pitch. Slightly right of centre, looks playing it towards Fernandez, who chests it down. Luke Evans gets a challenge in, a really good one as well. Argentina coach not happy that that wasn't given as a free kick, but play continues as Sheridan looks to roll past Luquez, but a good bit of defending on this near side by Rodrigo Luquez. And he finds Lugren into the feet of Bassi. And a great tackle by Evans, but Bassi rides it somehow. He's still got the ball here and takes a shot on, but he's dragged it rather aimlessly wide. He's better than that, Bassi. But encouraging applause again from the Argentine bench. It was great play to ride the challenge of Evans.
Yeah, Evans is a big lad. And Bassi had the strength somehow, a real pocket dynamo. Got through the challenge. I think he's looking to strike across the ball, but ended up dragging it hopelessly to the left-hand side.
It's Lestrange with the goal kick for Ireland, then to this near side. Short to Markey. And he plays it long along the floor towards Sheridan, who picks it up on the edge of the centre circle in Argentine territory. Faced up by Luquez. Has to turn back for home and go to Luke Evans on halfway. Looks to feed it into the area towards McKee, and Molina was there. Just left of centre to feed it out for a throw on the far side. Good defending by Molina. And a tough character. Doesn't shy away from any tackles. That's a throw in to be taken by McKee. Rolls it in towards Sheridan, but Minesh Gupta on the far side signals for a corner kick. And it's a corner kick we all have to be taken by Gary Messett, and he's got a wonderful left foot from a set piece. Luke Evans coming up from the back. Sheridan is also in there. Flatty's in there as well. All tall players. Argentina not the tallest team.
No, certainly a height advantage here for Ireland. Three players lurking towards the top of the box. Their markers all considerably shorter than they are.
We have seen from the previous free kick, though, that Mariano Cortez has some leap on him. And it's he who isn't marking anyone. He's just marking the zone on the edge of the goal mouth.
Yeah, he did remarkably to get up and cut out the previous cross. And it might need the same again. It will go into that area with a left foot in swinger.
Here it is then from Messi. It's swung towards the far post. It's just over Luke Evans. Brings it down on the back of his shoulder and he slips. And here comes away. It's Matias Bassi. He's got Fernandez down the line to his right. He might not need him. Bassi still surging towards the edge of the penalty area to the right side of the area. Now Fernandez switches it back across and nearly an own goal from Sheridan back there. But it goes out for a corner in the end on the near side. Sheridan's so close to turning into his own net. But wonderful work from Bassi and then Fernandez.
Yeah, lightning counter-attack there. Evans losing his feet on a greasy surface. Bassi running upfield, found his teammate Fernandez. It was actually good defending by Sheridan. Had to make that block, but it didn't miss his near post by much.
Corner to taken on this near side by Molina. Fernandez comes short, picks it up from Molina, who turns it back to the corner taker, who swings in low left-footed, but it's read by Messett, who will try and get there first. It's great pace for Gary Messett, who's got the edge on Molina, surging up this near side to the corner of the penalty area. Takes a shot on low and hard, but it's well read by Nahuelkin to field it. And he gathers at the second attempt.
Yeah, goalkeeper really well positioned. Just came straight to his feet, but fantastic run down the left-hand side.
Deceptively quick is Gary Messett. And a great turn of speed from the Irishman. There's Argentina now on the ball as the raindrops start to fall around St George's Park. Lugren in the centre circle, turns and strikes a shot from range, but that will go deflected out for another corner.
Yeah, end-to-end at the moment. Quick counter-attacks, good dribbling from both teams. Another attacking opportunity for Argentina. Corner on the far side, in front of the terraces.
To be taken by Mariano Cortez, three in the middle, which is Bassi, Fernandez and Lugarin, all marked up. Only Sheridan left in the centre circle for Ireland, everyone else back defending it. It's Cortez who flights it in towards the penalty spot, and it's headed away by Messett. Only as far as Molina on halfway, then he feeds it back to the corner taker, Cortez, who keeps it in. And then swings it across towards the near post. That's comfortably gathered by Simon Lestrange, who spills it a little bit there, but he was under no real pressure, the goalkeeper in orange. And he gathers the second attempt. And the number 14 now can roll it out to this near side for Joe Markey. And he goes long down the line towards Sheridan. That's a beautiful touch in his left foot to bring it down. Luquez at his back. Stands him up now. And Sheridan looks to go down the wing. Good pace from Sheridan, gets the better of Luquez. Can he find the cross? He can. Great ball in as well towards the far post, but McKee had ran to the net. But great play once more from Sheridan.
Yeah, really good from Sheridan. Just stopping and starting and stopping again. Really good change of speed and got to the byline, and it's a beautiful whipped in cross, just begging for someone to get on the end of it.
Yeah, so much Crossy would have wanted Sheridan on the end of it, really. There's a throw-in on the far side, taking shots of Lucas. He hammers clear into the centre circle for Fernandez. He gets there first ahead of Evans. And then gets the ricochet back. Fernandez on this near side now. Feeds it back up the line to Molina, who's now crossing halfway on this near side. Ball into the middle from Fernandez. Good feet from Bassi once more onto his left foot. Edge of the penalty area. Feeds it back to Molina, who plays that to the far side now for Cortez. Looks to swing in across, but that's well defended. And they'll go out for a throw on the far side for Cortez to take. Rolls it in low to Bassi. Looks to turn once again. Pass Messett. He does well. Bassi keeps holding it. Messett with one challenge, and he wins it off him. The big number seven. Great battle between those two. And Messett turns away from the challenge of Bassi once more. Flights a long ball towards Sheridan. It bounces all the way through. Oh, and Nowelkin had to make a save there. It nearly crept into that far post. And Nowelkin down low to his right-hand side. Almost caught out.
Yeah, the long pass just evaded Sheridan. But then it skipped off the surface and skidded along, gained speed almost as it landed. In the end, it's a decent save from the Argentine keeper.
Yeah, he's almost caught out, the Argentine goalkeeper. Nowelkin. And it's Messett who's trotted over onto this near side to be taken the corner kick. He's taking his time about it, Gary Messett. He has expended a decent amount of energy in this first half. Forerunners of this Irish team. He's played about 20 minutes of it. Goes in towards the far post. Evans was rising, but Bassi predictably was with him and makes the header clear to the far side for an Irish throw.
Yeah, that one just evades everyone and goes out to the far side. Still 0-0 here, but it's an intriguing one, Steve.
It really is. Plenty of action to describe, if not quite the goals, but a great turn of foot there from Sheridan, but he's well tackled by Lucas, who gets it away to Bassi in the centre circle, but it's well defended by Ireland by Markey, and he feeds it out to the right-hand side of Argentina's half for McKee, but that's well cleared in the middle by Molina, headed back into Argentine territory by Luke Evans, and that'll be an Argentina throw right by the edge of their penalty area on this far side.
It's just what you want to see from your centre-back, a really committed header from Evans. Flew about 5 yards in the air.
It's Cortez on the far side, who rolls in short behind him to Lucas. Those two look to exchange passes, but pressure from McKee has seen Argentina lose the ball, and McKee has a throw-in now. Taken in towards Sheridan, then hammered out by Lucas for an Ireland, corner on the far side. Messed over to take again.
Yeah, Evans up from the back again as well, making his way towards the far post. Captain.
Bassi marking Evans. It's Lucas marking Sheridan. He's floating towards the far post where Sheridan looks to peel away. That's going to go past him and for a goal kick. If Argentina, to be taken by Nowelkin. And the Argentina players shuttle out to positions. And here's the right defender, Pablo Molina. He goes down the line to Bassi. Running the show for Argentina. It's a great ball down the line to Matias Fernandez. Corner of the box, stood up by Joe Markey. Quick feet from Fernandez, but he can't quite find Bassi on the edge of the penalty area. Messett intercepted, and Luke Evans can get it away. And that's a really good ball from Evans to this near side, holding halfway for Dylan Sheridan. Turns in field, but then turns into the tackle of Fernandez. Rides one, rides two. Does really well here, Sheridan, but he can't get across past the challenge of Rodrigo Lucas. Ireland keep the ball on the one halfway, and Messett turns onto his left foot. And he's challenged by Bassi, and gives away the free kick. Looked like he couldn't really get out of the way there. Messett rather jumped into him, but Keith Stroud was assertive. Free kick to Ireland.
Yeah, same battle again. Bassi along with Gary Messett. Messett winning the free kick this time. But we saw moments ago, Messett, just the way he covers and reads the game, so important.
And those two in the midfield, Messett and Bassi, enjoying a real titanic battle in this first half. And they've got to be really careful. Both of them, of course, on a booking after that incident about 5 minutes in.
Yeah, the type of players are involved in everything as well in that midfield. Always going to be running the tightrope on the yellow card.
Messett then to take the free kick. It's a good 25, maybe 30 yards out. Left-footed, two men in the Argentine wall. It's curled in low. It goes all the way through. Nowelkin makes a really useful save, you know. Deflected right in front of him, and he had to react.
Yeah, good hands from the goalkeeper with players around him. That ball came in low and took a wicked bounce just before it got to him.
Floated down the Argentina left then for Cortez on the halfway line, but it's intercepted by Evans. Cortez slides in aggressively and wins the ball, and great feet from Bassi to nick it away from Evans once more, and he's brought down rather crudely on the far side, almost in revenge for taking it away from Evans in the first place and the Irish skipper, you'd imagine, will go into the book for that.
Yeah, the referee went straight to his pocket there, actually. He's already got the card in his hand. Bassey, good turn of pace, just knocked the ball past Evans, and it was a cynical one. I think he knew exactly what he was doing.
Good little shuffle of feet there from Bassey, right to left foot, quickly changing lanes with the ball. And it's going to be contested over the free kick. About 10 yards side or so inside the Irish half. On the far side, he's got three to aim at in the middle. One of them is Bassey, who rises highest and gets the flick on. It falls off Evans, and Simon Lestrange in the end claims it in both hands. He bumps into Lugren, who's taking a bit of a knock there. The referee just pausing play. But Bassey isn't the biggest, but he really has a great leap on him. Him and Cortez, in particular, real athletes in this Argentina team. And Lugren has stayed down here after colliding with Lestrange, the goalkeeper, and the physio comes on for Ireland.
Yeah, one of the better set pieces today. We've had a number, not many have connected with their man, but that one did. Ball just looped up though, never really threatened the goal. And despite the changeable weather and the slate grey skies here, it is still warm. And they're taking on some fluids in front of us.
Yeah, the Argentina team have worked very hard in the midfield in particular. And by definition, as it's very even, so have the Ireland team. And both sides just taking the opportunity to get some extra instruction from their coaches. Ireland led today by Gerard Glynn. Today and every other day. But Gerard Glynn in the technical area now dishing out some instructions to his boys. And Osvaldo Jorge Hernandez, rather fetchingly dressed in a all black number, black shirt and black trousers and black shoes. And looking very similar to yourself, actually, Bob.
Yeah, well, we are sartorial geniuses. He's looked great all week as the Argentine coach.
But away from St George's Fashion Week and back to the football, we'll restart with Simon Lestrange in goal for Ireland, who plays it out to his right-hand side for Luke Evans. Rodrigo Lugren happily is able to continue as Luke Evans plays into the Argentine half for Sheridan, gets it back to Evans. It's floated long down the field towards the Argentine area, but it's well headed away by Cortez. Only as far as the corner flag, he looks to battle it out with Sheridan, and in the end that's gone for a corner to Ireland over on the far side. And Messett predictably walks over to take it. Luke Evans equally as predictably up from the back, that big tall defender. Him and Bassey will reignite their rivalry. Two men inside the area for Ireland, and one of them, oh, was Luke Evans, but it's headed over his own bar by Matthias Bassey. Very, very close to an own goal there.
He looked determined to score in his own net. A diving header, and I don't quite know what he was trying to achieve as it whistles past his own bar.
In the end, he has achieved a successful clearance for another Ireland corner, whipped into the near post, and that time it's Evans with a flick on at the near post, and Ireland come close again.
I think it was Bassey actually got just in front of his man and then flicked it across the goal face and out for a corner on this near side now.
That's the decision that's been given, and Messett trots across to take, this time on the near side. Same targets in the middle. Eric O'Flaherty also lurking on the edge of the box now, just to add to the mix. He's marked by Cortez. Messett flights another one in. It's towards the far post, a really good header by Luke Evans, and a good save high to his left by Nahuelkin to pull it away.
More good goalkeeping from Nahuelkin. Good positioning and a really good save with the left port. Over the top of the bar it goes and out for another corner on the far side.
Messett to take then with his left foot. Same targets in the middle. Fourth corner in a row for Ireland, swinging towards the near post. Nahuelkin claims at the second attempt as a yes, palmed it down and then gathered. Good goalkeeping from the man in red, and he'll launch it up the field out of his hands. Header on by Evans in half, on halfway, and he's brought down Bassey. He rather slipped there, Evans, but he did bring down the Argentina player. And that will be a free kick. And it's bang on the centre spot for Argentina.
He's got to be a bit careful, Evans, there. He did slip, but he denied a possible attacking opportunity for Argentina, and he was booked earlier in the game.
Yeah, a few players on a booking if you've just joined us. Ireland nil, Argentina nil. We head towards the end of this first half. It's Molina who takes a free kick long and hard towards goal, but in the end, ultimately wide. Needs to be on target if you're going to attempt a free kick like that.
Yeah, decent connection, but not on target. Long way out to try something from there. And it goes past the goalkeeper's right post.
And it's back now with Ireland. On this near side, it's Joe Markey who plays it into the Argentina half, and Sheridan holds it up well to play it to O'Flaherty, but great work again from Lugren to get it away. And here comes Fernandez on this near side, on halfway, flicks it into the middle towards Lugren. Great gather from him as he beats one man but runs into another, who's Gary Messett, who's been everywhere in this first half for the Irish. when he turns away from two to get it down the line to McKee. Brilliant from Messett. Advantage being played. Fernandez wins it, but it falls here for Sheridan, who skips away from one. Chance here for Ryland on the edge of the area. Sheridan, and he buries it over the bar. Dug out the shot from underneath his feet, and a really good opportunity for Dylan Sheridan. Best of the half, and it goes over the top. And a booking over there on the far side for the foul, and Messett for Mariano Cortez, who becomes the second Argentina player in the book. But all about Sheridan there, what a chance.
Yeah, Sheridan rocks his head back and looks at the skies. He'd done the hard work. A lovely bit of skill to knock it past the defender. Left the defender on his behind, and the shot blazed over.
Best chance of the first half comes right towards the end of it for Dylan Sheridan. Played about 27, 28 minutes, got a couple of minutes left of this first period. It's with Argentina on the far side, and they win themselves a throw. Cortez will roll it in quickly to Bassi, turning away. Challenged by Messi, who snaps into the tackle and wins it off him. What a battle that's been in the first half. Played up to the front then by Ireland to Dylan Sheridan, who gets onto his favoured left foot, edge of the penalty area, takes a shot, and it's a good block by Molina. But Sheridan looking increasingly more dangerous.
Yeah, a few opportunities for Sheridan now. He's causing them all kinds of problems with his movement and his pace. He does have fast feet. He's a tall, lanky fella. And he said quick feet and a good left foot, causing some problems.
There's Messett, who will come across onto this left-hand side again to take another Irish corner. There's been quite a few of these. I barely have to tell you who's in the box for it now. It's Luke Evans and Dylan Sheridan, joined on the edge by Eric O'Flaherty. Ireland go again from the corner kick. Flighted in. It's towards Luke Evans, who gets the header in. It doesn't quite fall for Sheridan. It's hooked away by that man, Bassi. So halfway to Joe Markey, who plays down the left-hand side for Messett. Stood up by Molina, cuts in field onto his right foot, Messett. And again, beats Bassi. Lovely play. Takes a shot right-footed this time, and it curls over the bar. Just got the sense he never really was comfortable taking it on his weaker foot, Messett. And that one was high and a little bit wide as well.
Yeah, a little bit of a swinger with the instep. Did so well to cut inside. Left two Argentine defenders for dead. And as he got to the edge of the deep, swung the shot in, but it was always rising.
He really is it's a bit of a cliche for a left-footed midfield player, but he is a cultured player, is Gary Messett. The fourth official just about to let us know how much stoppage time we're going to have at the end of this enthralling first half. Really no goals, but it's been a really entertaining game. And at 2 minutes we will have at the end of this first period, as Dylan Sheridan comes forward for Ireland towards the far side of the area, and it's well defended by Molina as Messett looked to turn it back inside. Now on the far side with Evans for a throw in. Middle of the Argentina half. McKee comes short, as does Sheridan towards the corner of the penalty area on that far side. Checked back towards Luke Evans, who then comes back to halfway for Gary Messett. We place it to the near side here, but that's overhit rarely from Messett. It's a rare loose pass from the Irish number seven, who shakes his head in frustration. And that goes out for a goal kick.
Yeah, didn't give his centre forward McKee much of a chance with that one.
Here's Molina from the goal kick on the near side. He lofts it long down the line. Won't quite be kept in by Bassi in the just inside the Irish half on the near side. Be a throw in. Taken by O'Flaherty. Back to Messett, who spins it up the line, and Sheridan will get his foot on this. Looks to turn inside the left-hand side of the area. Just looks to creep it in the near post. It was an ambitious effort, shall we say. But he goes straight into the side netting.
Yeah, very tight angle, just inside the box. A yard or so from the touchline, from the dead ball line. There was a gap, though. Nicole and Helquin had left his near post empty, but it was into the side netting.
Here comes Molina from the goal kick, then, on this near side. Down the line to Lugren, who turns beautifully past O'Flaherty. It's a low centre of gravity, Lugren, but he can't quite keep it in. Ran out of room in the end. But it will be an Argentina throw. Which might be a touch fortuitous decision. Not sure Flaherty got a touch on that, but assistant referee signals it anyway. Molina now on halfway with the throw in on this near side. Well, he's given a free kick, has he? He has. And it's Molina then to take. Fall forward for Argentina inside the area. Molina booms one towards the far post. It's Bassi rising, but rising highest is Luke Evans with a huge leap to head it away to the far side. And it stays in to prevent a corner kick for Ireland, but it does go out for a throw in on the far side. But Keith Stroud blows his whistle for the final time in this first half, and we end the first period goalless, but an enthralling game nevertheless between the Republic of Ireland and Argentina.
Yeah, absolutely. The midfield battle has been a really good one. Well competitive. Both teams with some probably the star men in there, to be honest, Stephen. Messett and Bassi, both booked, of course, as well. So there's plenty of spice in this game. Still 0-0.
Plenty to play for then in the second half of this classification game. The winner of this will head into the fifth, sixth playoff, remember. So it's a very important game for both sides. And we will find out the outcome of it and whether we need extra time in the second half in 15 minutes' time. Go grab yourself a refreshment, whether you're inside the venue or on the live stream, and we'll see you for the second half.
full time. We will have 10 minutes in either direction of extra time, followed by a penalty shootout if required, to see who goes forward to the 5th and 6th place playoff and who goes to the 7th and 8th place playoff. So extra time and penalties if it's all level at full time, but we've got half an hour of football before we get there. It is the second half of our third round match. Argentina against the Republic of Ireland.
Welcome back for the second half of this intriguing tie between Argentina and Republic of Ireland. Republic of Ireland wearing all green with white numbering and a white collar. Argentina wearing all blue with white socks and white trim. Argentina will shoot right to left and in this second half, and Republic of Ireland left to right. We're up the commentary position. It's just left of the Argentine dugout with the Hilton Hotel complex to the right hand side and the terraces with the spreading of spectators on the opposite corner. And it's Ireland who have an early attack to the byline. Header comes in. And the referee's already blown the whistle. And it'll be a free kick over on the far side. On the far side to Argentina. No, it is a free kick. Rolled back into play. Sets position and an opportunity to send it long here for Pablo Molina. He sends it up over halfway, 30 yards. One in the middle by Massett. Bassi again has it now for Argentina. Steps over a foot inside the centre circle and beats his man. Coming forward now, striding forward, Bassi. Drives inside the penalty area. Tangle of leads and Fernandez goes down. But it goes through to the goalkeeper. Goalkeeper Lestrange in an orange jersey. Holds it in his right hand. No cap for him today. It's a cloudy day. Drops of rain in the first half, but nothing at the moment. And here comes Markey up the left side towards halfway. Diagonal ball, won't find its intended target, and Argentina will pick it up at the left back position and play it along the touchline. And Evans wandering across from the centre of defence, gets it out of play right in front of us for an Argentine throw-in. Scrappy start to this second half. But here's Bassi, he might add a touch of class, cutting inside, tries a pass across the box and it just escapes the intended target. Captain Rodrigo Lugrin, the distinctive figure with the long fair hair, just couldn't quite get on the end of that diagonal ball that bounced across the box and out of play for a goal kick, which Lestrange will take. Right footed and into the left back position for Markey, who first time sends it across the box to Evans, who's able to stroll forward unmarked and chip it into Sheridan. Man on his back, loses out. And now Bassi has it at the top of the centre circle. Uses Molina. Back to Bassi. Looking for options. And plays it with the outside of the foot towards Fernandez, who's under pressure from Evans. It bounces off Evans and ends up back at Bassi, who shakes off Massett momentarily and comes forward, prods it past Evans. A chance here, possibly for Argentina. Good strength from Evans. Sees it out beyond the dead ball line and it'll be a corner kick.
Yeah, brilliant for Luke Evans. The two probably quickest players on the field. And Evans did so well to hold off Matthias Bassi, who's sometimes unsuppressible, really. But he did so well there, the big defender, to get there first under a lot of pressure.
Yeah, it did look as if Bassi would get on the end of that, but didn't in the end. And his will be a cross, in outswinging, right-footed, it's low, towards the penalty spot. Poked away and out to the D. Fernandez this time starts again, goes out to the far side, in line with the penalty area, crossed in, and good covering by Joe Markey. We'll have another corner. Good work on the edge of the box for Argentina. A little exchange of passes, a little triangle. Sent it towards the terraces, but the cross was blocked. And chance again, this time it's comes in high to right under the goalkeeper's bar. Really good defensive header from Evans and it bounces outside the box. Fernandez looking for options, finds Lugrin. Massett snapping around him, but it goes away to Molina on the far side. Shapes to shoot, cuts inside. Lugrin will shoot, left footed, really good save, batters it down and it's hooked away by Markey. Back in again from Argentina and Markey can clear it for a corner kick.
Clinging on a touch here at Ireland, and Argentina can sense it. The dugout right next to us up in arms. They're trying to persuade their team on to try and get them a goal. Really strong start to the second half by Argentina.
Yeah, ramping up the pressure. And here comes another corner. This time it's low to the near post. Bassi goes for a flick and it comes all the way to the outside and it's blocked on the line and sent away towards halfway, where Argentina retrieve it again. But a tussle means Sheridan could be in here. He's won it and he's away, heading towards the penalty area. On his left foot, bends it towards the corner. Well saved. Really good save by the goalkeeper. who sort of anticipated it and dropped to his right-hand side and turns it round the post.
What a save, Gustavo Nahuelkin. Wonderful goalkeeping to deny Sheridan. That's the most open chance we've seen in the entire game. Sheridan spinning away, one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Oceans of time to think about it. He picked his spot, and Nahuelkin was equal to it. That's a brilliant save.
Yeah, and for this corner's taken, it's a change for Ireland. Eric O'Flaherty, the number five, slumps away to the bench. He's replaced by Lisi, and here comes the corner straight away. Chance for Evans immediately. Misheads it, and in the end, it's headed behind by Bassi. But Evans, unmarked, in line with the far post, sort of more headed it further up than he did towards the goal. And we'll have a repeat corner from the same side. That's the far side as we look at it. It'll come in left-footed, driven across the box towards Evans again. Evades him, and now he collects it with back to goal, heading towards the corner flag. Under pressure, nibbling at his heels is Bassi. And in the end, it goes out for a goal kick. Just couldn't quite keep it in there, Evans.
I think he's given a free kick on this near side for a foul by Evans.
And that's rather unusual. It was Bassi at his back. He was sort of nibbling and clipping away at his heels. But anyway, free kick it is, which is passed short inside and then returned. And it's Cortez, who sends it infield now to Luquez, strolling through midfield and through the centre circle. Finds the tenacious Bassi with his back to goal. Looks up, clips it right-footed. Taken on the chest here by Lugren. Really good challenge, an important one by the substitute for Ireland, who eventually, at the second time of asking, chips it away to the far side, and it'll be a throw-in in line with the penalty area.
Yeah, straight into the action there, Parik Lisi. Important intervention as well to deny Lugren, who is a player who can just about control any ball that's fired into him. Great touch.
Rolled into Fernandez. Clever scoop ball and a 1-2. Fernandez has it back, and it's well read by Evans, who puts a boot in and sends it back out on the half, on the far side for a throw-in. A little bit of a conference between players here for Argentina.
Yeah, it's been a really strong half to the really strong start to the half by Argentina.
Here's Bassi, finds Fernandez in some fantastic boots, cuts it inside, and it's cut out by Massett, who sends it long and direct, and Sheridan's got the pace to get in behind here, looking for help. Ball cut out, a crucial interception, but Sheridan has it again towards the byline, approaching the area, chips it in the middle, might come to the far post, chance for a first time shot, well saved. It was the number eight, Carl McKee, just drifting in on this right-hand side, picked up the cross as it was drifting as it was sent across, and it was a shot which was saved down to the goalkeeper's right-hand side. In the meantime, there's a man down on his back, the number four it is, that's Rodrigo Luquez.
Yeah, don't really see what happened there with Luquez. It's I think it's just another collision. He's just been attended to by the Argentina physio. We see on this near side, Mariano Cortez receiving some instruction from the coaches. But it's, as we say, it's been a free-flowing attacking start to the half from Argentina. They've been by far the better side at the beginning of this second period. It was a very even first half, but in the second one, Argentina are very much on top. And the old adage of you need to score when you're playing well, never does it apply more than in knockout football. One mistake, as we saw on halfway when Sheridan ran through, could put paid to you.
Going to restart with a bounce ball. And Nahuelkin is able just to wander up towards the edge of his box and play it left-footed to his right, to the right-back position. Poked into the centre circle, and then back it goes all the way to the D to Molina. Just trotting and prancing around the ball, looking for options, and then drives forward towards halfway. Takes Sheridan out of play by cutting across him, still going into the half, and his pass eventually cut out by Evans, and Messick can bring it away through the left channel. Left foot ball first time is cut out, and Evans again battling. He's a fantastic defender, but Argentina have it back, and here's Fernandez, the number 11, on the far side, faces up his marker, that's Markey, and then beats him with a lovely bit of skill into the box now, driving, plays it across the 6-yard box, and it dribbles away out of play for a goal kick.
Really, really good player by Matias Fernandez. He's a most deceptively quick player. He's not too quick across the ground, but his immediate acceleration, his quick feet really do make up for that. And Markey was bamboozled there by the turn. It was a wonderful piece of skill from Matias Fernandez.
Yeah, it's a sharp bit of skill with the touch with the outside of the boot and that pace over 2 or 3 yards, making the space, but no one's there to connect with the cross. And Lestrange will get us underway. Sent high. over halfway, and one with a really firm header, which Fernandez brings down and tries a clever flick over the top. Marquis covering it and heads it out towards the near side, and Bassi will collect it in the orange boots. The short man shrugs his man off and then chips a ball to the far post. You could see what he was trying, trying to find Lugrin as he came off the right-hand side, but it goes out for a goal kick. Those two have looked to combine a few times, Steve.
Yeah, Bassi and Lugrin are a little bit of a double act. They combine really well together. Both have very good technical ability. Both very tenacious in the tackle. They're very similar players in a way.
Evans now on the near side, deep inside his own half, progressing towards halfway. Tries a ball along the floor, but it's easily cut out by the mobile Bassi. Bassi's pass is a sloppy one. And in the end, Ireland gain territory and have a throw in midway inside the Argentine half. McKee looks to take it, takes it orthodox down the line towards Sheridan with the man at his back. Turns with his foot on the ball and nutmegs him cleverly, coming towards the area. Chance here for Sheridan. Half deflected and well saved. Brilliant stuff from Sheridan. Fast feet, took two men out of play before his shot on target.
Yeah, some absolutely outrageous skill there from Sheridan. I think if he'd have curled that into the back of the net, it would have been up there for one of the goals of the tournament. Absolutely brilliant skill. And a very good save again from Nahuelkin. He's been equal to just about every shot.
Yeah, the short and stocky Argentine keeper having some game. And it's marshalled out of play on the far side by Messett. That'll be a throw in to Argentina, which Pablo Marina trots over to take and rolls it short to Lugrin. Here's Molina again, drifting inside, looking for options. Has the ball on his right foot, 25 yards from goal, pokes it to the edge of the deep. Receives it back, edge of the box now, cuts inside, chance for Molina on the left foot, strikes it and goes over the bar. I think Lestrange had it covered, he was watching it all the way, and it flies harmlessly over his crossbar.
Yeah, you can tell Molina's weaker foot is his left, wasn't quite struck with as much conviction as he would have liked. Struck a little bit under the ball, leant back, got it well over the bar in the end.
Here's Markey on the left side, under pressure from Fernandez, manages to poke it forward. He's gone down in a heap. An apologetic hand from Fernandez suggests this will be a free kick. And it will be. Markey gets to his feet to take it and plays it inside. Here comes Evans, a drop of the shoulder, gets him through the centre circle and gives it to Messett, who wants it on his left foot, cuts back on that left foot and chips it forward, but Bassi's there in company and receives it in the stomach and goes down. Here comes Markey as we play on, over on the far side, in line with the penalty area. Good bit of defending from Molina, and he shepherds it out and will have a chance to stop.
Yeah, Bassi, I think, just winded by that ball. It caught him right in the bottom of the ribs, and he just needs a moment to recover. I think he will be fine. You could see there he's while he's on the floor, he's trying to breathe as rapidly as he could to get the wind back into. He's one of those players who really hates being down, you feel, not running around and playing football. He's a really, you know, he's just a tenacious character. He just wants to be on the ball all the time. He's infectious in that Argentina team.
Yeah, we've seen a few players in this tournament and remain nameless who've gone down for no reason. But this is this looks like an honest one from Bassi. The referee walked over, offered him the physio, and he wagged his finger, denying him the chance to bring the physio on. And he's back to his feet after an unusual routine with a colleague. And here come Argentina. Long, long ball sent deep towards the penalty area. Fernandez trying to go left to right to collect it, but Evans shadows him all the way and just pokes it out with the toe for a throw-in on the far side. Players drifting forward for Argentina. Four inside the half. The fifth coming into the Irish half now. And it's Lugrin, the captain, wearing the armband on the left arm. Short sleeves for the Argentine team, which is brave. Here's Molina, chipped forward. Fernandez might get on this. Just inside the six-yard box, turns and pokes it towards goal. Ooh. And between the post and the goalkeeper, it stays out.
Yeah, Sheridan only just gathered that. It looked for a moment like it was going to squirm underneath him. Really inventive effort from Fernandez.
Sheridan poking it infield, but there's Bassi again. Intercepts it, and a cultured pass forward towards Lugrin. Lugrin sort of gets away from him in the end, and it allows the number six, Perek Lisi, to come across and kick it out on the far side.
Argentina got away with that one there. That was definitely an Ireland throw on the far side. It deflected off Lugrin. The assistant referee on the far side, Gupta, didn't quite see that. Argentina's ball.
Bassi, man on his back, half turn, then squares him up on his left foot now. Bassi does have both feet available to him. He's a really good player in that way. Number two sends it forward into the box, and then sliding as Cortez loses out, and Evans can bring it away on the near side. Looking for options, they usually head for Sheridan and do again, but Sheridan's not chasing this one with any conviction. He's getting away from him, and it's collected by Nahuelkin. Inside his box, number 12 in the red shirt, chips it wide. And here is that number two, Pablo Molina. He's been involved in quite a lot today, and it slides into the centre circle. where it's collected by Argentina's number 5 and played down the line towards Fernandez, the number 11, with Markey at his back, heading for the byline, now forced back towards the corner flag, manages to face Markey up, looking for options, puts his foot on it, tries to slide it to Bassi, and it escapes them out for a goal kick.
Yeah, Argentina have been really impressive in this game, as of Ireland, of course, very even game. But you just wonder, why didn't Argentina start this team when they went out to the Netherlands in the quarterfinals? It just does make you wonder. They look so much more effective today than they were that day.
Yeah. There isn't too much between Marana and Bassi, however. Marana did have a fantastic game, but this side does look a little bit more balanced than the one that got beaten by Brazil. Le Grint just trotting over for a throw-in. No real urgency for Argentina. And it's going to be rolled in by the looks of his body position, and he rolls it in short to Bassi. Receives it back, Le Grin in the green boots, barged off it, but it falls to Molina, who pokes it inside. Bassi now goes down, it's bad chuckle from Messi, and he could be in trouble here.
He's got to be careful, Gary Messi, he really has. This might, I think, judging by the referee's reaction, be a final warning. There won't be too many more of these. And Keith Stroud just laying down the law, but that was a late challenge, and it stopped Bassi from advancing. And you see there the hand signals from the referee. Very much, that is the final one. And Messi is treading a tightrope.
We did warn that that little area was a problem for both teams. Two players who love a challenge, both booked early in the first half. Here comes Molina. Lots of players around the goal mouth. It goes right over everybody and it's a poor one.
That's a real waste for Molina. He's much better than that. He knows it. He's got four Argentina players in the middle. In the end, he's fizzed it way over all of them. Not a chance for any of them to get anywhere near it. Real, real waste from Argentina.
Strange. A short ball, 15 yards to the right back position, where Evans sends it high, taken down on the chest by Sheridan. Man on his back, runs into trouble, but deflects away. And Ireland retain possession. Messi poking it out to the right side to Sheridan. Lovely interplay between the two of them. And here comes Messi towards the edge of the box. Cuts inside on the left foot, looks to shoot. And it just slices away, and it's helped by the wind that's blowing from behind us. And goes away out to the far side. And it'll be a goal kick to Argentina.
Yeah, couldn't quite just wrap his foot around that, could he, Messi? It was a touch behind him as well, which I don't think helped. But a decent half chance for Ireland.
Yeah, made himself some room really cleverly. He'd be disappointed. Miscontrol from Bassi on the far side. And Ireland now will have a throw-in. And again, they look to just sort of slow the pace and the tempo of this game down. Argentina, much more comfortable in possession, you feel. But the direct play towards Sheridan has been useful all day. And here is Sheridan again. Look at the pace of him. He goes past his man, number 4. Sheridan now, still with the ball on his left foot, looks to cross, sends it high to the back post. Chance for Messi, turns it round. It's blocked pretty much on the goal line by Mariano Cortez. And we're just over halfway through this second half. And it's still 0-0, but a good opportunity to change the scoreline there for Ireland.
Yeah, you get the feeling there's goals in this one. You can't see it ending 0-0. Hope I haven't just put the curse on it by saying that.
Messi sends it in high towards the back post. Sheridan looking to head it down, can only head it up. And out for a goal kick.
Yeah, both sides could so easily be in front in this game. It's been really even. A couple of chances for either side. Both goalkeepers have played really well. And you are struggling to see how it's going to end 0-0. But it's been a long time at this scoreline as Ireland prepare a sub.
Yeah, it's Jason Moran receiving his last instructions. Right, sent long by Argentina into the Irish half. Good header from Messi. Straight to Sheridan again, who, despite having a man on his back, makes a half turn, and it bounces out to Messi, who's barged off it, and Argentina win a throw in inside their own half, which Molina will take. No sign of the substitution being made yet for Ireland. The man's still on the touchline as Molina comes forward towards halfway, going right to left in field, cuts back and then pokes a ball to Bassi with a man round him, that's Sheridan. He steps away from him, chips it wide. It's gone beyond Molina, who can't get there, and out harmlessly for a throw in on the far side for Ireland. And this is the substitution, and you can only feel it's because he's walking that tightrope. It'll be Gary Messi who comes off, and Jason Moran, the man who's coming on. Some rather unusual behaviour from the coaching staff here from Argentina, throwing bottles around. They don't look happy at all, as Messi really just plods his way off. Still not made his way to the byline. Finally shakes the hand of a teammate, and the change is made. Big physical figure, number 13 for Ireland, and he trots up to an advanced position. Sheridan's dropped deeper here.
Yeah, he'll run all day, Jason Moran. He's a really, really hard-working forward.
Meanwhile, Fernandez, another who's run himself into the ground, has the ball on the far side, cuts in field, pretty unchallenged, slides it to Molina, edge of the D. Molina looking for options, gives it away cheaply, and Evans it is who collects it, trying to inject some urgency into things. Evans hits the ball straight up into the face of Lugren, who collapses like a sack of spuds, and the referee immediately stops play. It's gone straight up into his face there, Steve.
That is a stinger. I think we all felt that around the pitch here. He looks like he's going to be okay, but that will have certainly hurt him in the immediate aftermath. He's back on his feet now, Lugren.
Yeah, one to make the eyes water, that one. As Fernandez sportingly kicks it back to Lestrange. He gratefully bends down, collects it, and places it on the floor again. Plays a short ball, quite often he does, here to the near side, to Evans, right in front of our commentary position. Sends it long, a slip in the centre of the field from Argentina. Isn't fruitful for Ireland in the end. Just a moment there where you thought the slip by Rodrigo Luquez might have allowed Ireland in, but it's received by the goalkeeper comfortably in the end. And Argentina get us underway again. A bit of exchange of passing across the back before it's poked forward to this near side. Cortez coming forward. Little exchange of passes with Fernandez. Molina now, edge of the D, sliding shot is blocked and cleared by Markey. And here's the first bit of action for Morant. Number four for Argentina, does really well and covers him. And via a green shirt, it goes out for a throw-in on the far side.
More enthusiastic encouragement from the Argentine dugout on our right-hand side. Still no substitutes being made by Argentina, interestingly.
Here comes Lugren, turning out. And shot from a long way out, will just dribble past the post. Didn't really get hold of it. He sort of drifted inside on his left foot. Not much options on, so took the shot on. But it was a daisy cutter that sort of dribbled by the goalkeeper's left post. And Lestrange will place it on the edge of his technical area and get us underway with a goal kick that sends this time to the left-hand side to Markey. And Markey trundles forward and spends a lofted ball, and there's good covering from Argentina. Heads it straight out. Out of play for another throw-in on the far side.
Yeah, that man Bassi again. I don't think there's a blade of grass on this pitch that he hasn't actually covered. Matias Bassi, he's been absolutely everywhere for Argentina.
Seems to have dropped deeper. Molina sort of swapping places and coming a little further up the field. And here come the Irish, poked wide now. Cross comes in, left-footed, edge of the D. Moran can't get to it, but McKee will collect it. Corner of the box, and a really good challenge by Cortez. And Fernandez might get hold of this on halfway. Is able to, in those lovely boots. Step over twice, and then pokes it wide. Short passes exchanged, and Bassi romping forward from the back. Short pass now, just inside the Irish half. Inside Irish box, sorry. Poked pass. Chance for Fernandez to shoot. Instead, passes it wide to Molina, and it's cleared away from under his own bar, really, by Sheridan. Moran does well to hold it up here with the man at his back. Still no options for him. Will be forced back. He goes back to into the left-back position for Markey. He brings it forward 20, 30 yards unchallenged. Still going. Bassi comes snapping in, but he's able to pass it before Bassi can get to him. Exchange of passes on the touchline. Doesn't work out, and it goes out for an Argentine throw.
Yeah, good chance, actually, for Argentina on their last attack, just a note. But it was a disappointing end to it. Molina had no options really available to him in the middle. And there was no one really to cross to. It's a decent ball in from Molina, decent chance.
Ireland capitalising on some sloppiness from Argentina, and the shot comes in from a long way out by Sheridan, and goes a long way over the bar too. Went almost as high as it did far. And the Argentina will have a goal kick. A little bit of movement on the Argentine bench, but no sign of a substitute. Here they come again, the number four, Rodrigo Luquez, chipped out to the left-hand side, right on halfway now. Cortez, down the line. Fernandez, with a man at his back, looking for a difficult pass, and it's gone straight to McKee, who steps past one challenge, but it was a poor one, rather crude from Mariano Cortez. We'll come back for a free kick.
Yeah, no contact there from Cortez. It didn't seem to impede McKee. I'm not sure I'd have given a free kick for that, but again, I'm not the trained referee, Keith Stroud is.
I think the player did quite well to evade the challenge. The ball was a good five, six yards away from the tackle. So Evans plays it infield, inside the centre circle to Markey, his fellow defender, who's looking to shoot from range. It's from a long way out, left-footed, and it curls over the bar.
Yeah, he's had a couple of those, Markey. He had one in the first half, which whistled just wide of the post. That one, not quite as effective, but he's certainly got a bit of a cannon in that left foot of his.
Here come Argentina again. It's sent more direct for them, and Sheridan is there to intercept it and put it out. Different threat, Ireland, now with Sheridan deeper.
Yeah, absolutely, and Moran is not going to give the Argentina defender's a moment's piece. He's a really, really hard-working forward, as I mentioned when he came on. And interestingly, Bassi Molina swap has now swapped back.
Here's Lugrin coming in field, might shoot, does take a shot, it's deflected, and it's well saved. It, for a moment, it looked like it might just creep under Lestrange, but he got his hands down to it, and a good save. Sort of skidding and skipping shot from Lugrin again, cutting in from that right flank and hitting it left-footed. Here are Ireland now, on the far side, in line with the penalty area. It's the substitute, Moran. Oh, and he's brought down in the end by Luquez, and it'll be a free kick near the corner flag. Good hold-up play again. It's a traditional centre-forward, Steve.
Yeah, he really is. He's the old-fashioned number nine, as we'd say here in England. It's really good forward play. He's just difficult to get off the ball. He'll bring other people into play, and he's got a decent finish on him as well, Moran, when he's given the opportunities to shoot, but it's one of those who's just a nuisance to defenders. Defenders hate playing against him.
Yeah, sort of tall man with a barreled frame. It's a long way round him to steal that ball, and he does shield it really well. Free kick to come in from Sheridan. Raises his right arm. In comes left-footed, really good cross into a dangerous area, and it's bundled in. And there's fury on the Argentine bench and absolute, well, elation on the Irish bench. They're jumping all over the goal scorer. It's Evans, the captain. It was swung into a dangerous area right underneath the bar, and it's bodies flying at it, and Evans is the one that touches it home.
And the Argentina team just trying to take the kick off again quickly, but the referee having none of it. And what a moment that is for Ireland's really, really important goal in the context of this tournament for them. Luke Evans, the captain, leading by example with a brave header at the near post to sneak it in past Nohuelkin in the Argentine goal. What an important goal for Ireland.
It shows you how much these rankings mean when you see celebrations like that. And this is over fifth. Here comes Bassi. Bit of urgency from him now, up against Sheridan. Physical with each other. And then snapping tackle from Sheridan. Puts it out for a throw-in on the far side, but both players going shoulder to shoulder. 5 minutes or so, possibly less to go in this game. 1-0 to Ireland.
What an important goal to score, and what a time to score it. Ireland have probably been second best in this second half. But it is they who lead, and what a good header it was from Luke Evans, who has led by example all day from the back. And Argentina prepping another change. It's going to be Claudio Figueroa to come on eventually.
Here's Molina, chipped into the box for Argentina. Bassi flicks it on. Possibilities here, and good save. Just not enough purchase on it from Cortez. And Lestrange flops to his left-hand side and grasps it to his chest. Another save for him.
Yeah, it's a decent save from Lestrange. Cortez just wasn't quite enough power on the ball for him to use. He had to generate all the power himself, and that's a free kick.
This is a nasty challenge, this one. Very late from Fernandez. Studs look to be up as well, and he's left his Irish player in a crumpled heap. He acknowledges the yellow card, Fernandez. Can't argue with that. And it'll be a free kick on the far side. In the meantime, we have two substitutes waiting to come on. Fourth official just waiting for confirmation that he can take these substitutions, and it'll be the number two. That's Pablo Molina to be replaced by Figueroa, the part-time goalkeeper with a number one on the shirt. You don't often see that in an outfielder. And he makes his way up front, a big, tall presence. And for Ireland, it looks like it's going to be Sheridan, which is somewhat surprising, given the game that he's had today. And it was his delivery that was bundled in. And on comes Ryan Nolan. Ryan Nolan, tall figure, short hair, an Irish suntan. And we have a free kick on the far side, still waiting to be taken. Sent long. Here's Moran, near the corner flag, won't get there, and in fact it hits the corner flag and bounces out, and a goal kick's the decision.
Yeah, Argentina now have played all their cards, all subs used. Argentina still have two to use, but they might have time to use them if they can't force extra time in these final few moments.
Poked inside, here's Bassi, bringing up over halfway. It's a scuffed pass, but it'll find Fernandez. Tries to look for Bassi again, and he's crowded out, and here comes Nolan for Ireland. Turns about 360 and finds Moran, but he loses out to Bassi, who's tracked back. A little step over from Bassi, commits his man. It's poked into the box for Figueroa. Figueroa cuts back towards a chance here for Bassi, and it goes wide, and he puts his shirt in his mouth. And it's a real opportunity. Really good stuff from Figueroa. Turn, pokes it inside. Bassi had kept his run. Left-hand side, centre of the penalty area, and he scuffed it with the outside of the boot.
What a big chance that is for Matias Bassi, a player of his quality, who we really expected to score. Argentina dugout to just the right of me going absolutely crazy. They thought they had their equaliser.
Their entertainment on their own. But there's some good stuff still going on out there, and Evans plays it along the floor, and this will go away on the far side for a throw-in, which Lugren runs over to collect. Real urgency in this now from Argentina. Bassi heading backwards, turns his man and manages to half escape before he's well tackled by Nolan. And then Nolan's strength holds him off and he plays it forward. Moran will try and get there on the left-hand side, in line with the penalty area. Man on his back, as ever, that's Luquez. And Luquez manages to stab a tackle in and gives away a corner kick, which Ireland will have on the far side. Not long remaining in this one, and Ireland won't rush over this. And I don't know how many they'll commit to it either. Moran's put it in the corner flag, put it by the corner flag, and there's not a man in the box. Exchange of passes, and in fact they're just going to keep it by the corner flag. The big strong Moran just loses out, and it eventually bubbles out for a goal kick to Argentina.
Yeah, well played by Bassi there to get themselves a goal kick, but Alvia's last action, he's about to be replaced.
Yeah, Marana will come on. He had a good game a couple of days ago. Marana, the number 10, stronger figure, but he's again, he dictates the tempo in that midfield for Argentina. And well, Bassi looks so disappointed with that miss. Shirt over his head, a look of disdain on his face, and he wipes his eyes and heads for the bench. Anyway, we carry on here with an Argentine throw on the far side, not far from the Irish penalty box. And it's rolled in by Lugren. Fernandez, who covers the width of the field, has it on the right wing position, and it's a good tackle. 3 minutes of time added on to play here. It's so well poised. Here's Morana, first touches of the game. And again, Nolan, who's made a real difference since he came on, making the tackle. Long throw comes in towards the box. Half cleared by Ireland. Collected by Luquez. And again, it's Nolan snapping away at him. Lugren is able to poke the ball wide to Morana. And then again, it's half bundled through and they just can't get hold of the ball, Ireland. And away to the right-hand side it is with Argentina. Looks to cross, Morana. Sends it in, and it's a poor one off the toe and wide and out for a goal kick, and a bit of pressure relieved.
Yeah, that's a bit of respite for Ireland, much needed as well. Chance to get the ball down the field. Argentina, time slipping away. And the chance to compete for fifth and sixth place slipping through their hands.
Yeah, they've taken some time over this goal kick, Ireland, before it's sent long towards halfway. It's Lugren who wins it, but Markey has it back and he sends it long and left-footed. Half controlled by the Argentine defender, and it bubbles through to the goalkeeper. Nkwelkin sends it long. It'll bounce awkwardly, but Evans is there to head it up in the air towards halfway. Morana can't bring it down and ends up bundling into an Irish player. They play on with Nolan. A good tackle by Lugren, and it's away for a throw-in on the far side. It is frantic.
It really is, and it looks like Ireland are just about going to see it out, though. Argentina can't get a foot on the ball. They don't look like creating that final chance. It might just have gone for them.
Nolan throws down the line for Moran, who will look to hold it up near the corner flag, and that's where he's headed. And Luquez puts a toe in and sends it out for a throw-in on the far side, which again, he can just stroll over to take the Irish. Not committing any players forward.
Yeah, they're in no great hurry.
Short throw-in. And Lisi and Moran try and keep it in the corner. And they win another throw-in. And this is precious seconds ticking down. It's agonising for Argentina. So frustrating. And the tension on the faces on the bench here next to us paint a real picture. And again, it's just a repeat play and out for another throw-in. And they'll look to do it again. Lisi it is who comes short. Man on his back and it's rolled short. And again, they try and hold it. And this time it's given away for a throw-in to Argentina, which is taken quickly by Lugren overhead to Morana. Morana busting forward, knee strapping on his left leg. Bright orange boots, looking for options. Inside the Ireland half now. Cross comes in, left footed, chance to shoot. Oh, and he can't get enough on it. Figuera. It was a really good ball in by Cortez from the left-hand side. And Figuera's scuff shot falls beautifully for Lestrange, who now delivers it long upfield. Moran's knee goes high and towards the corner flag on the far side. And Lugren's tracked all the way back to shepherd it out.
Might just be the final chance gone there for Argentina. They might just have one last chance to throw this one forward. Luquez bangs it up the field.
A huge kick, left-footed up towards halfway. Nolan it is again, who challenges well for it. But Morana finally gets it down to his feet and commits Nolan and pokes it wide to Cortez. Cortez forward towards Figuera again. It floats just by the bar and it evades everybody.
And that's it.
That's the final whistle. What a game. And disappointed faces in the Argentine bench. But the Irish all leap to their feet. It's hugs and smiles for them. A big win. 1-0 it is here in this classification game. They'll go on to play a fifth place playoff, and that'll be an intriguing tie in itself, Steve.
It certainly will. It is Ireland then who progress to the fifth place playoff to play against either England or the USA, and either one of those will be a mouth-watering clash. But a real disappointment here for Argentina. They look absolutely desolate. In particular, Matias Bassi, who is my man of the match, by the way. He looks so disappointed after missing that chance to get Argentina level with just moments to go. What a game.
Yeah, he's not forgiven himself, I don't think, the poor lad. But what a great game that was. A really enjoyable one. And we've got another one coming up for you at 1 o'clock. In the meantime, it's goodbye from me, Bobby Cowsill. And goodbye from Stephen Jameson. And we hope to look after you later on.